So when I think nostalgic TV shows, one of the first things that comes to mind is Jackie Chan Adventures. Jackie Chan Adventures was one of my favorite cartoons growing up, and where I was pretty much introduced to the legend that is Jackie Chan. I mean, yeah, it's a fictionalized version of him that he doesn't voice, but still. It's about Chan, who works for a secret organization called Section 13 that stopped dark magical forces from taking over the world. Along with his niece Jade, Uncle, and later big lovable tough guy Taru, he goes up against these magical dark forces. I love this show. I love the imagination, the action, the characters. It was exactly the kind of show that got my creative juices flowing when I was a kid. I remember rewatching the whole series on Netflix back in 2012 over the summer, and I watched the Christmas episode back in 2014 for that list I did, but haven't watched an episode since. So let's see if the Halloween episode is as good as I remember. This is Fright Fight Night. We start with Jackie as he tries to reenact the beginning to Star Trek V.
An Oni mask.
I have like 14 questions, but we don't have time. All that matters is that the Dark Hand wants that mask, and after a small scuffle, the mask ends up in a Halloween store.
Oh, that's convenient.
But don't worry, Jackie does manage to get it back without them even realizing.
There is no need to make mask removal potion.
Not this time, Uncle. The only masks you will see tonight will be on the faces of trick-or-treating children.
Like a 6 out of 10. So she dresses an Oni demon and hopes to win the costume contest at school that night. Is that the first time we've had one of those this month? You'd think that would have shown up a lot more. I love that Captain Black is a bald ego because America. Then El Toro shows up, and remember, El Toro Fuente never removes his mask.
I'm so glad you could join us for Halloween.
And next year, you and Jade must join us in Mexico for El Día de los Muertos, the Day of the Dead.
Well, I would have done Lizzie McGuire's Day of the Dead episode, but I ran out of slots. What do you want from me? Paco is also a wrestler, because of course he is. And while he wants to fight Jade, El Toro stops it.
Never forget the first rule of Lucha Libre. No wrestling outside the ring.
You think wrestling's second mightiest champion can be defeated by a girl?
No, he never said that. Like, even remotely. Also, Jade offends him by saying he'll lose the costume contest. Yeah, I never really cared for this kid. Jade could be annoying, but at least she was funny. This kid is just annoying. So in order to win, he takes the Oni mask that Jackie found.
Maybe you should have locked it in a vault.
Back with the bad guys, Ratso and Chow, who are still looking, which is kind of funny. The season's main antagonist, Terracudo, lets them know that they're stupid and Jackie has the mask. This guy's a decent villain, not the best, but certainly not the worst the series had to offer. So Paku puts on the mask and of course turns into a demon. He looks like a furry. So he runs away to do some trick-or-treating and ends up at Uncle's shop. Uncle is the best thing in this show.
Arr, matey! Why must Uncle devise removal potion now? Very nice Japanese Oni demon costume. Happy Halloween, thank you, goodbye.
I adore everything about this man. So as he and Taru go to fix up a potion, Terracudo meets Paco and says he will teach him to be scary.
Are you the Great Pumpkin?
Alright, totally spies may have been too wimpy to kill innocent people, but is Jackie Chan willing to do it? No, he just takes the candy. You mostly just ate plastic, you dumb little shit.
You there! Step away from me, Paquito!
I'm sorry. This little devil bows to a new master.
That's what I told my sister when her cat started liking me more. There's an interesting idea that they don't recognize that the minions he summons and thinks they're kids in costumes, but nothing really comes of it. And we get an action scene. This show did legit have a really well choreographed action, up there with Teen Titans and Avatar The Last Airbender. And there's a great scene with Taru having to go back and forth between fetching ingredients and handing out candy that leads to a young child getting an octopus tentacle.
Gnarly, dude!
Maybe he's into hentai and this is the best Halloween ever.
Jade tries to use her costume to stop the monsters, named the SquidCon, but it doesn't work. I like that. For a second I thought it would and I was gonna yell about it. So they kidnap Jade, but Jackie has an idea.
Trick or treat? Gracias, but I am on a special diet. Do you have onions?
Are you really doing this?
The onion field!
My eyes!
Ancient demon defeated by a vegetable.
Well, he's technically not defeated, but he gives them enough time to go to school where Paku wants to win best costume.
Ew!
About time Cthulhu showed up. Guess he had to take a break from harassing Kristen Stewart.
I am the scariest. Which means you no longer need to wear a mask.
But I'm not wearing a mask.
I know.
Jesus, this got intense real fast.
Thankfully, Arturo comes in and saves her. And Paco sets up an impromptu wrestling ring. But first up, Uncle.
Hands off, dude. It's mine.
Trade you.
So Arturo gets his ass handed to him.
Oh.
Smash him, Arturo!
Jade, it is still Paco.
I know what I said, Uncle Jackie. Smash him. Break his skull.
But unfortunately, they drop the potion to remove the mask, but through the power of love...
Paco, you must remove your mask.
But El Toro, you know the luchador must never remove his own mask.
Okay, listen, you little shit. That's just a silly thing we say. We still have to wash them. You think I'd be wearing this thing if I hadn't washed it in 10 years? He manages to get to the potion and take it off. Where Terracudo is in this whole thing, I'm not sure.
No more Halloween horror from you.
Jackie... He nearly killed all of you. Lay off the jokes.
Jade gives him the award because, quote, he's the champ, and we get the weekly message from the actual Jackie Chan.
Hey Jackie, do you like scary movies?
Yeah, okay, thanks, Ghostface. Is this when he was filming Around the World in 80 Days? I remember liking that movie. No idea if it holds up.
So that was Fright Fight Night, and it's... good.
It's not one of the better episodes of the show, as it was later in the series run, but it's still got the fun action, funny moments, and even some heart. As a Halloween episode, it's fine. It's got all the typical Halloween stuff like costumes and candy and scary masks and... Look, I'm running out of things to say. I've been doing this for 29 days straight. 7 out of 10 on both scales. It's a good episode, just nothing really spectacular.
Well, that's it for animated series. Tomorrow we go back to Disney sitcoms with Even Stevens. Yeah, I'm not even bothering with a hint. I'm tired, I'm hungry, I'm outside being hunted. I want to go home. See you tomorrow.